On to news overseas, a U.S. study shows Russia has been sending thousands of Ukrainian children in what the report describes as re-education camps. The study funded by the U.S. State Department said children as young as 4 months have been taken to 43 camps across Russia for pro-Moscow, patriotic, and military-related education. The report, which relied on satellite imagery and public accounts, said this could constitute a war crime. Ukraine's government recently said more than 14,000 children have been deported to Russia since its invasion. Moscow has cast the effort to saving orphans or bringing children for medical care. One of Cambodia's last independent news organizations is ordered shut down by the government. The Voice of Democracy lost its license to publish and broadcast after Prime Minister Hun Sen alleged the station's commentators targeted him and his son. He has rejected the station's apology. The VOD was one of the few media outfits to survive Cambodia's crackdown on civil expression. Its shutdown comes ahead of the country's elections in July. Let's now find out what other stories our North America Bureau is pursuing right now with our correspondent, Henny Espinosa.
Good morning, guys. Here are the latest stories making headlines in the Filipino community.
Pinon Pinos!
Yes, a China virus!
Pinon Pinos!
We begin in Los Angeles, where Filipino-American activist groups protested at the historic Filipino town Gateway, with the message that they opposed the Philippines becoming a gateway for the U.S. military.
Marcos Jr. is cementing deals that completely undermine the sovereignty of the Philippines and the long-term safety and security of the Filipino people.
Manila recently agreed to allow the U.S. military access to more military bases in the Philippines. It comes amid continuing maritime tensions between the Philippines and China in the West Philippine Sea and Chinese aggression over Taiwan.
Ultimately, what the Malaya movement wants is independent foreign policy so that we're not at the beck and call of any superpower or any of their geopolitical fights.
One.
Meanwhile, the work of Filipino-Canadian artist J.A. Tan is now on display at the Philippine Consulate in Vancouver in an exhibit called Mindscapes. Tan, who is autistic, said he painted a lot during the COVID-19 lockdown to keep calm. Tan's art has been cited by several notable bodies, including the United Nations, which issued a stamp with his painting to raise awareness for autism. His painting, First Movement, won second place in the Art of Autism's Finding Your Inner Mozart in 2019. For this exhibit, the fine arts graduate from Vancouver's Emily Carr University said the painting called The Road Ahead is his favorite.
It tells me after the pandemic, we want to move on and move forward.
Hey, Debbie.
Happy birthday, Peter.
20 years of friendship. Can you believe it?
How do you still speak to me?
And finally, in entertainment news, Debbie and Peter are two best friends who missed their opportunity to have a romantic relationship 20 years ago in the perfect for Valentine movie, Your Place or Mine. It stars Reese Witherspoon and Ashton Kutcher, who relish the chance to work together for the first time. They share their own experiences with second chances that changed their lives.
At like 10 years old, I broke into my high school, and I had like a third degree burglary offense against me, and I got a deferred judgment by the judge, who didn't know me, but looked at everything else that I had done. And decided to not give me a felony offense. And that single decision that individual judge made to not give me a felony, but give me a deferred judgment and give me probation, and so significantly changed the trajectory of my life.
I was in a really, really bad car accident 10 years ago. And there, I should have not survived, and I did. And it felt like a second chance.
All you have to do is take a chance.
I don't take chances.
Your Place or Mine is now streaming on Netflix.
And those were the latest headlines from North America. You can catch our stories online at news.abs-cbn.com/TFC News and on the ABS-CBN News YouTube channel.